Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome on board. October 30th, 1935 was a day when Boeing Company was completely ready, prepared to demonstrate their new state-of-the-art four turboprop engine airplane. It was called the prototype M299. They were hoping to sell it to the defense. And this was the aircraft which turned out to be the B-17 Flying Fortress. And it was one of the best and one of the top-notch bomber airplanes, and it served well in World War II. The prototype was completely ready. It did a normal departure, it took off very well, and right in front of the crowd, sabke samne aircraft just pitched up, stall hoke niche gira, it crashed. Investigation was carried out. Ki bhai ye hua kya? Itna top-notch aircraft. First flight mein, take-off karte crash. But anyways, investigation was carried out aur pata chala ki that aircraft had no mechanical failure. The aircraft was perfectly fine. What is the mistake? Well, the entire crew of that aircraft, they forgot to remove the gust locks. Gust locks kya hai? Yeah, gust locks. Ye chhoti locking mechanisms hoti hai, jo basically is either installed on the control columns inside the cockpit or the control surfaces outside the aircraft on the wings, elevators and rudders. And what do? They just help avoid inadvertent movement of these control surfaces when the aircraft is parked on the ground and it's a windy condition. Lesson learned that finally aircraft had surpassed the capabilities of human mind. Hawai jahaz bahut zyada complex ho raha tha. Itna zyada ki it is not possible for a human mind, even the best of the human minds, to remember everything in sequence. Hence, birth of the checklist. So, aaj ke date mein, ek single seater aircraft ho, yeah, for space shuttle, ho. You have checklist for every phase of flight. So, I was just thinking, why not do this one flight following the checklist? So, here we are at Agra Airport, and it's again one of the most simplistic, basic, but beautiful aircraft, Cessna 152. And mujhe iska checklist mila online, Google karke. So, let's follow the checklist and let's operate the flight. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride. So here we go. Cessna 152 pre-flight checklist. Cabin pre-flight inspection. Look at the first line. Remove gust locks and pitot cover if installed. So let's just skip the pre-flight. But let's go to before start engine. Okay, before start engine, point number one. Pre-flight inspection is complete. We are assuming we've already completed. Passenger briefing is completed. That's basically a briefing to be given to your fellow passenger in case he's not a pilot, is there for a joyride. And just to brief him about the safety instruction, what to do if we have to abort the departure, what to do and what not to do. Seat belts, shoulder harness, adjust and secure. Fuel shut off valve on. It lies somewhere over here. Okay. It's on. Circuit breakers check in. And these are the circuit breakers. They're all checked in. Radios and electrical equipment off. They are all off. Brakes test and set. Okay. Let's hit the brakes there. There it is. Parking brake released and parking brake is set. And there's a column for V speeds. There's basically V means velocity, and there's different speeds required for different phase of flight. Let's skip that part. Let's just remember the VR speed, which is 50 knots. VR means we rotate. There's a speed during the takeoff roll when we pull the control column back to liftoff. VR is 50 knots. Remember that. Starting engine. Okay, I'm gonna remove this control column. Starting engine mixture rich. There's the mixture control. 100%, let's switch. Throttle open 1/4. 1/4 or half of an inch. Carburetor heat off. Pulling gives it carb heat on. Down is off. Beacon light on. Okay, that beacon light is basically this part. It's not running now because there's no battery switch, but beacon light is also the anti-collision or basically that light gives the indication to the persons outside that I'm going to be starting my engines and to stay away. Prime as required. Sometimes they say pump three times. So that's one, two, three. Battery switch on. Okay, now the beacon light should be running. There it is. Propeller area clear. So before starting the engine, we have to see if it's clear on the left and also on the right. And in actual, what we do is basically we open up the window and we scream out, prop clear. And the personals in and around, they'll just check and they say, yeah, it's clear. So this guy over here is supposed to say, yeah, clear. And then we can start. Ignition engage. There we go. One, two, three, and the fourth is ignition. Okay, ignition is on. Engines are running. Do not crank more than 10 seconds. Okay, ours is already running. Throttle, 1000 RPM. There it is. We are at 1100. Let's get it back. It's a little less than 1000 RPM. Let me just adjust. Oil pressure indication green. There you go. Just coming up on green. Temperature is also green. Mixture lean. A little bit just for taxi. Alternator on. There you go. Ammeter check. So over here, it's either charging or discharging. So it's on the plus, it's charging. Flaps retract, it's all the way up. Navigation lights. So navigation light is on. Radios on, and they're already up and running. Transponder to standby. Let us switch the transponder code to 1200, which means VFR flight, visual flight rule. So the radars, when they get our aircraft information, they know that this guy is flying based on a visual reference and not based on navigational aids. Heading indicator is over here. So looks right, just about south, is aligned with the magnetic compass as well. And ATIS, we're supposed to listen to the ATIS that gives us weather information. Automated terminal information system. Altimeter is set. It is reading the elevation of the airfield, which is roughly about 550 feet. And we take the departure clearance or the taxi clearance. Next checklist is the taxi checklist, where we check the brakes, instrument cross check. We'll just go through it one by one. Parking brake released. Brakes check, right brake, left brake. Instrument cross check, how do we do that? And we do an S pattern. Starting with this. Altimeters, clock, artificial horizon, or the attitude indicator, airspeed, turn, slip coordinator, direction indicator, vertical speed, and the VOR again. They're all on green. This is coming up on green. It's okay. She'll come up. Okay, let's taxi onto the runway. Okay, there's a hold shot marking. Let's hold shot here before entering the runway. Let's do the before takeoff checklist. Before takeoff checklist. Nose wheel straight. It was straight, brake set and hold. Flight controls free and correct. Okay, let's check. It is checked, fuel shutoff valve on. It was on. Mixture rich. So it's 100%. Throttle 1700 RPM. There's the RPM, that's 15, 16 and 17. So let's increase the thrust of the throttle to 1700 RPM. Okay, that's just about 1700 RPM. Carburetor heat, check drop. So what we do now is, we're gonna pull this carb heat to on and see how much the RPM drops. About 1000, or I would say 900. Okay, magnetos, check. Okay, there we've got, we have two magnetos on board, right, left, and both. The key is always set on both. So what happens is basically we have two magnetos. Both the magnetos are connected to spark plugs. So the magnetos are basically the ones which are providing electricity to give spark for the combustion inside the engine. So we have to see how good is each magneto. How we do that? Right now the RPM is set at 1700 RPM. We put the key to right first, that is 1, 2, and check the drop. It shouldn't drop more than 125. So that's just about 50. So that's good. Get back to both. 1700 RPM. Now let's check the left one. Just about 25-50. Back to both. Magneto check is good. Engine gauges and ammeter, they all look good. Kick onion, suction, green arc, throttle, check idle, throttle 1000 RPM, throttle friction lock, as adjust, which is basically you just turn the throttle like a screw. And got communication navigation radio set, flight instruments set and checked, they all look good to me. And fuel quantity is checked as well, got roughly less than 50%. Trim is set for takeoff, there it is. This point should be set at takeoff, it's good enough. Flaps set for takeoff, let's go for flaps 10 degrees. And there the flaps are out. Cabin doors and windows closed and latched. It's all good to go. Seats, adjusted lock, departure briefing, clearance, emergency plan, and advisory tower contact. Now we contact tower, we request the takeoff permission. How do we get in? Before getting in, we should always put the landing lights on, strobe lights on, and as you spot it, we are assuming we've already contacted tower. So once you're cleared for takeoff, lights as required, we've already put in the strobe and the landing lights on. Transponder, yeah, I forgot. They put to altitude. Whoops. There's a vehicle crossing the runway. Okay, continue with the checklist and lights as required. Transponder to alt. Brakes is released, traffic check. Okay, we got a traffic over here, small van. Anyways, you can ignore that part. Normal takeoff, wing flaps 0 to 10 degrees, already set at 10. Carburetor heat is cold. throttle full open, left nose, and then elevator control, left nose at 50 knots, climb speed 60 to 75 knots, flap retract if applicable. We will retract the flap at about 300 feet above ground, so we're at about 550. So about 900 feet will, 800 and 900 feet will retract the flaps. So let's get going. Brakes released. Throttle full. Airspeed is alive. And 55 knots already crossed. There we go. Let's climb to about 2,000 feet and maintain. I visited Taj Mahal in 2015, and I've seen the pictures of I've seen thousands of pictures of Taj Mahal before, but never did I think that when I see it actually, I'll realize how beautiful it actually is. It literally takes your breath away. Taj Mahal is beautiful. It's looking beautiful now. Look at that. Taj Mahal turned out to be so beautiful that I believe Shah Jahan wanted to build the exact same replica on the opposite side of the bank. If you see, the foundation is still there, and he wanted to make a black Taj Mahal. You see, the foundation of the other Taj Mahal is already here, but apparently he ran out of money, he couldn't afford. Have you ever heard of Tejo Mahale? Apparently, one of the historians, Professor Oak, wrote a book published in 1989. The name was Taj Mahal, The True Story. It's controversial. It's worth a read. It's fun to read. Let's get a little crazy, shall we? Something we can't do in real life. Okay, that was a lot. Let's head back home. Continue with the checklist. It is in checklist. 8 is obtained, so that we know the latest terminal information weather-wise. Altimeter is set. Arrival passengers brief. Mixture adjust as required. Power as required. Carburetor heat as required. Landing lights on. Wing flaps as required. Before landing, seats, belts, and shoulder harness adjust and lock. Mixture as required. Carburetor heat is on. Normal landing, power as required. Airspeed, flaps up 70 knots, wing flaps as required. Airspeed, flaps down 60 knots. Touchdown, main wheels first. Brakes apply as necessary. Okay, after landing checklist, flaps up, mixture lean for taxi, carburetor heat is off, landing light off, transponder to standby, and taxi clearance. Okay, that's just about it. Just to show you the importance of checklist. Securing airplane checklist. Radios, electrical equipment off. Throttle idle. Magnetos. Check grounding. Throttle 1000 RPM. Less than that. Ignition off. Mixture idle cutoff. Master switch off, beacon off, control lock installed, flight information record, pitot tube cover installed, wheel chokes ties down, post flight walk around, doors locked, securing airplane checklist complete. So that's just about it for today. Thanks again for flying with your virtual captain. I'll see you again in the next video. Ciao.